I started thinking about my Tiny Chat experience today. Now, I went into the Tiny Chat room, and I didn't hear anybody in there talking, so I decided to start talking myself. So I said, "Peace, peace, all terrorists will be rehabbed." I think that's what I said, and I think once I said, "All terrorists will be rehabbed," I think they immediately got offended. Or some of the people in the room immediately got offended. I think that's what it was. Look at that. Now, if these were real men of peace, they would have said, "Amen, brother. Amen." Ah. Ah. See? Now, let me repeat that again. When I entered the room, I said, "Peace, peace, peace. All terrorists will be rehabbed." And then some of their immediate response was, "Who the hell are you? What the? Shut up!" Ah! Attitude, instant attitude. It didn't matter what they said. The tone of voice gave it all away. They got offended just like that. Boom. That's a terrorist act. Did you not know that? Yeah. To get offended is a terrorist act. And then to put icing on the cake with the tone of your voice and ridiculing verbiage, intimidating verbiage, that's fuel to the fire. Now the intimidating act gets more flammable. Think about that. Let's repeat that again. Anybody that gets offended has just committed a terrorist act. Think about that. Anybody that gets offended has just performed a terrorist act. A terrorist action. To be offended. Now, there's a difference between being offended and rooting out terrorism. Because sometimes to root out terrorism, you've got to go in with a gun. See what I'm saying? And if you maintain your peace and your calm, you'll be much more effective. If you start getting an attitude, then your effectiveness drops. The tone in your voice. But remember, if you raise your voice, there's a difference between raising your voice in the form of warning for the sake of peace and safety, For instance, if you got someone that's just about to fall into a manhole that's open in the street, you raise your voice, say, "Hey, watch out, watch out!" If you're a SWAT team and you're going into for a raid, you open the door, you say, "Hey, get down, get down, get down, get down! On the ground, on the ground, hands behind your back, on the ground, hands up, on the ground!" Or hands out in front of you like a fish. But if you go in as a SWAT team and you're doing a raid, you say, "Get out, get out!" Now you're full of hate and rage. Different. There's a difference there, see? If you're raising your voice to ridicule someone, that's an attitude. That's a terrorist act. If you're raising your voice with a tone of peace and safety, that's a just act. And believe me, the vibrations of your intention flare out. And they go through the air, and everyone feels it. And with the power of your thoughts behind it, you'll be able to control the situation for a just cause, or if you have the power of your thoughts and an attitude for a negative cause, then the people will feel that. And that's hate. And people remember hate. And they'll think to themselves, some of them might think to themselves, "I'm going to get that sucker. His day's coming. I'm going to get him back." But if you go in with justice, "Hey, hey, 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 settle down, settle down, settle down, settle down." See the difference between going in hate and rage? There's the difference. One's in total control. One is losing it. One's coming from the most high brain, justice. One's coming from the animal brain, the kill or kill be world of the jungle. Ah! See? Wisdom, understanding, knowledge. Get it. See? Your thoughts rule your intentions. And your intention radiates like an aura, like a pebble dropped in a pond. And your intention affects every other cell out here, all other cells, whether they're made up of human bodies and human brains, or trees, or cats, or dogs, or dirt, or plants, rocks, grass, fish, water. If this is a cup of water, and I have nasty, mean intentions, this water feels it, and all the cells in it get all distorted. And when you drink it, you just drank a mirror of your own attitude. And it is not healthy water. But if you have a cup of water, and you have peace in your mind, joy and gladness, all those little cells that make up that water will be all, woo, yeah, and you drink it, that's healthy water going in, mixing in with the rest of the cells, and the cells are like, oh, yeah, we're friends, yeah, get along, we get along, yeah, we get along, yeah. See how that works? Are you just, or are you a terrorist? Think about it. Seeing how we live in Prison Planet, it is a world of duality. So we have to look at both sides of the fence. Until such a time as we make that shift where the majority of the population learns to be just. And they will. We're on the road. We're on the evolutionary road. And it's coming in a quantum leap. We're going to take a quantum leap here. Mark my words. All it takes is that one man whose thought is so powerful it can bring a whole earth of thoughts to rise quickly. For growth, to replace the amputation that happened. The amputation. If we are all not operating at full capacity of joy, health, and life, then we've been amputated. Part of our body is missing. We are not whole. We're missing something. We're missing peace, justice, and life in its whole bodily form. Remember, we are all one. But if part of our body is diseased, and disease is just another word for terrorized, terrorism, Terror is the use of intimidation. Getting easily offended. All that comes from the animal brain, and that's where King David operated out of. That's why he could not build the temple. And he knew it. Because he was a man of blood. Come against me, I'll come against you. And I'll win. But that attitude had to happen. And Mother Nature fueled it. Because Mother Nature's goal is to get rid of all terrorist acts on her planet, which is her body. She is tired of parts of her cells of her body being diseased. And so we need to bring rehabilitation to Mother's cells. You see? We need to gather around the terrorist diseased cells with our healthy, just selves and put our intentions of healing upon them, upon the diseased, terrorized cells. Put our thoughts on it. You will be healed and whole and just. And the rooster will crow and let you know that the commercial lean is the hammer that drives the nail with one blow. Otherwise known as an air gun, as in Air Force. And the Navy, and the Army. Think about these things. Whipple, wapple, snipple, snapple, snipple, wipple, dipe, have a little kite, wimping, peeping. Tockle, have a little whip, nip a little nap, soup a little sap, have a little. All right, that's enough for this recording. Okay.